Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In this episode, I would scratch a tiny little itch, namely that QMessageBox do not offer a do not show again checkbox. You know, do not tell me this again and again. So when you've heard it enough times, just click the do not show again and it will never come up again. I'll implement a class for exactly this. I am sure you have imagination enough to know what it looks like, but nevertheless, looks like this. Continue watching Qt Widgets and More. Okay. Show it again. Continue watching Qt Widgets and More. Okay. Ah, come on. I don't want to be asked again. Okay, I said. And now whenever I try to bring it up, you can see down here that it continues saying okay. Here's another one. And if I say, nah, don't bother again, next time it will activate cancel right away. I can clear all of these and I'm back at what? Did I just say do not continue anymore? Well, we will continue nevertheless. And of course, it has a quit button. Had this been a Stack Overflow article, it would just say, well, since Qt 5.2, there is a method on QMessageBox called set checkbox. Just use that and be done with it. And that's exactly what I'll do. But in the spirit of Qt Widgets and More, getting you just a bit further, I'll show you the implementation of such a do not show again message box class that is subclassing from QMessageBox. And as you can see, it does indeed subclass from QMessageBox. It has the same static information method that you know from QMessageBox, except that it now takes a key as the very first parameter. It has this clear all, which is what was executed when I said, well, clear all, the concept of remove all the do not show again information so we can start all over again. And it has a private constructor if I want it has a private constructor for the implementation of this message box itself. And it remembers the key. There really isn't all that much to say in here. My information simply creates a do not show message box again, a static one, and it set up all these things and called execute on it. Execute checks whether I actually want to show, because you can see that there's this settings in my KDAB QWidgets and More do not show again subsection. And if it contains the key, then simply return that. Otherwise, do the real exec. And again, I have the setting, when I did exec, if the checkbox was checked, then save this into my settings and return the actual button selected. My clear all simply removes in the queue settings. And down here is the trick that made this episode worthwhile, namely create a new checkbox, call it do not show again, and call set checkbox. And as you can see here on the help, this one was introduced in Qt 5.2. I admit this wasn't the most groundbreaking episode. It wasn't like, well, I don't know, one of the other episodes I was groundbreaking. But nevertheless, if you haven't thought of do not show again for your checkboxes, maybe it's worthwhile just copying this code out and put it into your project so that you're just this ultra more polite towards your users that doesn't need to see the same message again and again and again. I'm Jesper Pedersen. You've been watching Qt Widgets and More, and in the notes below, please let me know what you'd like to hear about. Otherwise, this might end soon. Who knows? I am slowly running out of ideas. Until next time, well, you know, have a great time.